Money talk. Money talk. Money
talk. Money talk. Supreme justice. Supreme justice. Supreme
justice. Money talk. Money talk. Money talk. Money talk. Money talk.
I'ma let my money talk. Money talk.
Money talk.
I'ma let my money talk. Money talk. When I step up in the club, you know the ladies show me love. I don't speak, I let my money talk.
Money talk. Money talk.
I'ma let my money talk. Money talk.
Money talk.
I'ma let my money talk. Money talk.
Money talk.
Ladies drop it low, cause you know I got that dough. I don't speak, I let my money talk.
Know I make it rain, know I make it rain. Throw it in the air, I'm a thousandaire. You know you see the chain.
Know you see the chain.
I've been real before the fame. I know you heard the name. Put in the pot, then I double up. Niggas call me, then I answer, then I leave. Could you tell that I'm coming up? Niggas know I let my money talk.
Whoa.
My bad bitch, she gon' drop it for me. In the club, throwin' one, see the funds, you know she gon' pop it for me. And niggas stay on that paper chase. So much work, you think I make the base. Never say nothing behind a nigga back that I can't say in his face. Haters know I'm on that money shit.
Money shit.
Fuck around and catch a honey clip.
Whoa.
Niggas talkin' trash, gonna make a nigga slide off with his honey dip.
Yeah.
That's a couple racks when I come out. Triple up with no sun out.
Sun out.
Shorty in the club, make a nigga wanna fuck, dancing with a tongue out.
Now
flip up the flow. I'm getting the dough. I'm letting it go. All for the low.
For the
I'm ready
low.
To blow. She dropping it low.
She dropping it low.
And you know I got that money talk. I don't speak much in a club. I let that money talk.
Money talk.
Money talk.
I'ma let my money talk.
Money talk. Money talk.
I'ma let my money talk.
Money talk.
When I step up in the club, you know the ladies show me love. I don't speak, I let my money talk.
Money talk. Money talk.
I'ma let my money talk.
Money talk.
Money talk. I'ma let my money talk.
Money talk. Money talk.
Ladies drop it low, cause you know I got that dough. I don't speak, I let my money talk.
This is how I'm coming.
I'm getting money, I'ma let it stack. I double up, flip it up, re-in up. Nigga, I'ma bring it back. Music drops, she gon' make it bounce. Drop it low for a real nigga. In the club, ladies show a nigga love. Gucci on, no hill figure. You know a nigga, let that money talk. Hit the block and get them bunnies off. I hit the block, get the bread. Niggas know a nigga got that heart of salt. Niggas know I'm on a paper route. In the booth, you know the ape is out. In the club, spinning bread, spinning checks, niggas know the cake is out. Y'all niggas know I'm on some money shit. Came off a 100 clip. Came home with nothing, now niggas stunting on some other shit. When I pull up, it's in a mothership. Baby girl, make it clap for me. Hit the floor, throw it back for me. Hit the floor, throw it back for me. This is the time, I'm ready to climb. I'm back in my grind, this is the time. My shorty, she fine, her body is mine.
Her body is mine.
And you know I got that money walk. When I'm in the club, I don't speak, I let that money talk.
That money talk.
I'ma let my money talk. I'ma let my money talk.
Money talk.
When I step up in the club, you know the ladies show me love. I don't speak, I let my money talk.
Money talk. Money talk.
I'ma let my money talk.
That was Money Talk, everybody, by Supreme Justice.
You already know Supreme Justice in the building. Brick City on, Jersey zone. Let's get it.
Welcome, welcome. Hey, everybody. This is Taylor, and this is Indie Dreams, a show for up-and-coming entrepreneurs and artists.
Yeah.
Welcome to the show.
Hey, thanks for having me. You know what I mean? You hit me up. You told me to come through. I don't do no stunting. Pull straight up.
Thanks for coming. Thanks for keeping your word.
Word.
So how you doing today?
Everything's good, man. I'm coming here. You heard the money talk. I got two more records for y'all. I'm going to kick a freestyle. I'm letting y'all know Jersey in the building.
Right. I'm ready. Right. I'm ready.
Yeah. That's how we get down. Let's get it. Talk to me.
You was in the studio yesterday, huh?
I'm in the studio. I got a studio in my basement, so I'll be in there cooking up magic, different joints, trying to get there, man, trying to get out there. You already know how we coming.
Yeah. Well, were you working on something new? Or?
Well, the last joint I did last night, two nights ago. It's the song that you're going to play, How You Want It. That's the next joint I guess y'all going to play. But, you know, I just try to hit different markets. I'm definitely trying to collab with different people. I'll be doing a lot of different shows. Jersey got a lot of creative and good artists, male,
definitely.
Female.
Mm-hmm.
We just not getting the proper exposure that we really need and we really deserve.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just trying to do whatever I can, you know, keep it alive.
And I agree. That's why I had the show. You know, give a platform for artists.
Hey.
So contact me if you're an artist, entrepreneur. So before we get into to the interview with Supreme Justice,
let's go.
We're gonna cover our spotlight segment.
Okay.
Talking about what went on in hip hop this week. Mm-hmm. And this week, I don't know if everyone heard, but Little Duval came out with Black Men Don't Cheat.
Yeah, I heard about that. Black Men Don't Cheat.
And they put out that track, and it received a lot of, you know, good criticism and bad criticism.
Yeah.
And he went to Twitter and announced, "Today we celebrate all of the men who try to be faithful."
Mm-hmm.
So take a look at that. Take a look at the video.
About to play the video?
Mm-hmm. Okay. She gonna play the video.
Ooh, ooh. Black men don't cheat. Speaking my truth, man. Ooh, ooh. We speaking our truth. Ooh, from a male point of view. Black men, stand up. Come on. No matter what they say or what you heard in the streets, everybody knows
Black men don't cheat.
A lot of TLC, but we don't ever creep, so F what you heard.
Black men don't cheat.
Whoever saying otherwise just lied through their teeth, cause everybody knows
Black men don't cheat.
So next time you out, they try to jam you in the streets, you make sure you tell them
Black men don't cheat.
Hey, I love my old lady, that's my baby, think I'm leaving her for you. Bitch, you crazy. The hoes will attack. No matter where you are, I got two words for you. Faithful and black. I know you, man. Big, big man. I'm an honest black man. You can't put me on blast. So screenshot a nigga. We just gon' laugh. Duval ain't shit. She already know that. No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
I got a girl and you not hurt.
No,
you can try.
You can try.
Have a seat. I'm a black man, girl. I don't cheat.
We don't cheat.
So no matter what they say or what you heard in the streets, everybody knows
Black men don't cheat.
A lot of TLC, but we don't ever creep, so F what you heard.
Black men don't cheat.
Whoever saying otherwise.
So that was Black Men Don't Cheat. And it got the track yesterday. It was a couple days ago on Breakfast Club featuring Charlamagne Tha God. So I think it was a really dope song.
Like they said, when I first went to it, they trying to change the narrative. When you hear about black men, automatically he's a dog.
Right.
He is, she is. So,
yeah.
You know, that's their best shot. Not the best shot, but that's their shot of making a song to try to, you know, reverse the narrative. I give them full props for bringing that type of positive energy, for changing the narrative. But black men are cheating now, unfortunately.
It's got a little old school flow to it. It's a mixture, so it was different putting it out there, and I just appreciate the fact, because just being a black woman, we need to uplift our kings.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
And they saying, and not only are they saying the right things, you know, if you could put that into action and make it a lot more exciting,
put it into action, I believe so. But then we had I seen a lot of negative feedback from women on Facebook and saying things like, Black men don't cheat. What?
Well, black men do cheat, but they're not really understanding what they're trying to do.
Right.
They're not saying black men don't cheat, mm-hmm. saying that black men don't cheat.
Right.
They're saying it to try to bring it to awareness and try to
change it. And that's why I appreciate the concept of it. Yeah, so shout out to Lil Duval and Charlamagne Tha God for that. You know, I appreciate the effort for that, to change the way we think and stuff. So the next topic is hip hop's next billionaires,
mm-hmm.
and we all know the first billionaire,
Jay-Z.
So
Jay-Z, I ain't going front, man. Jay-Z is definitely an inspiration. You know mm-hmm. what I mean? Because he went from quote unquote drug dealer,
right, status, and
to being an actual corporate billionaire. Like that's
business.
Yeah, right. that's the goal for me. You know what I mean? Right now, I'm kind of like flip-flopping, and I'm trying to make the transition from being somebody from the street to somebody to being a corporate billionaire. So that's
right.
Just definitely inspiration for anybody that's trying to make it out and get it out of the mud.
Right. And in 2007, Jay-Z made a statement about his future fortunes. He said, I'm already the GOAT. The next stop is the Billy. And mm-hmm. He achieved it.
First they said Dr. Dre achieved it. And then once he did all the mathematical calculations, they right. realized, oh,
not to laugh, but yeah.
He didn't do it. But Jay-Z is definitely, he's the first.
Right, he is the first. And also, it was a statement in Forbes that they said, Jay-Z's entire life is the real blueprint. You know, and I think he tried to accomplish that when he made his album, when he was talking about making investments and stuff. Some people got it, some people really didn't, you know, appreciate it. But I mean, now he's showing he is really an example. He is a real blueprint.
Yeah, I definitely give him much props. He's definitely an inspiration.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just deeper than music. You know what I mean? It's just deeper than what he's saying in the music. You know, you might not like them. You might like them as an artist. You might not like them as an artist. That's your opinion. But you definitely got to respect his business savvy and his business move. And that's the inspiration for everybody.
And to be written in Forbes, you know.
Hey, man.
That's a really big
accomplishment. That's a dream. That's a dream. Mm-hmm. My dream. You know, everyone's dream.
So who's next? What do y'all think? Who do you think probably might be next?
To the next artist?
The next billionaire.
The next billionaire is Supreme Justice, man. I can't even start, man. I can't go over the head without saying I'm a thousandaire right now.
Uh-huh.
I got a long way for a billionaire. I ain't gonna be up here starting on the radio.
Right.
But I'm a thousandaire trying to get to the status. But everybody out here trying to be the next billionaire, man. If that's not what you're trying to do, then you'll give it up.
Right. So the next one that we in Forbes, they say Forbes reported that Drake.
Mm-hmm.
The next one with mm-hmm. he comes in with $150 million.
He's up next.
Mm-hmm. His fortune grew 50% within the last year,
mm-hmm.
and they said pretty much more so like real estate,
mm-hmm.
Whiskey, and excess nightclubs. So he made pretty much a lot off of those investments.
Yeah, I ain't going front, man. You know, a lot of the people that's up in higher places, they be up there, but they don't show you the way though. You know,
they
show you they up there, ha ha ha, look at all the money I got, but mm-hmm. they don't show you, you know, the moves. So that's what's different between Supreme Justice and other artists. I feel like if I ever get in position, I definitely try to show people the way.
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, that's true. You know, and I feel like they should probably put more platforms out there, more, you know, educational material.
Yeah,
out there.
Show us the way, man. Mm-hmm. What's the way? I know you're a billionaire, but what?
Yeah.
What I gotta
classes,
do?
Classes, yeah, exactly.
What I gotta do?
And I think that's why a lot of people, when they get up there, when they finally make it, they're reluctant to help.
They don't wanna show
like
you.
They said about with Nicki Minaj. I mean, I feel it with Nicki Minaj when she said, well, she said she wasn't like that, but a lot of people were saying that she really didn't want to do a lot of collabs with a lot of people.
Show me, man. You know what I mean? I ain't the type of person. I don't do no handouts.
Mm-hmm.
I ain't the type of person to do no handouts.
Right.
But you could point it in the right direction, though. You know what I mean? And I'm going to do the rest.
Right. Mm-hmm. So the next one was Kanye West, mm-hmm. who came in with $240 million. Now I see Kanye making some progress because Kanye, he has the Yeezys, you know, and also he did something new now, and he had a get together from Sunday Service. It's invitation only, and he was making some money off that. You know, he had people come, and he was inviting people to this church service and made pretty much a fortune.
Yeah. So, you know, artists, and once you get in the door and you got a name established and you mm-hmm. got the, you know, now you just following the money train, mm-hmm. you know, after that. So shout out to everybody that got in the door.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out to everybody that's trying to get in the door.
Word.
And that's what I'm about.
Mm-hmm.
You know, people that's in the door, they going to make their money, man.
Right.
I'm trying to get Jersey in the door, man. The last person we really had in the door was, what, like Fetty Wap or something like that?
Mm-hmm.
And that's cool, you know, but, you know, Jersey got to open the door for Jersey.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you go to Chicago, you go to down south, you go to, you know, any places, they open the door for their own people.
Mm-hmm.
And here it's like a crab in a bucket type, or if you're about to make it, I'm about to try to pull you down and try not to let you shine. But that's our stigma, and that's what we got to change. Jersey, stand up.
Jersey. And the last one, well, the last two that I had Diddy, who came with $740 million, and then also with Dr. Dre.
Mm-hmm.
Dr. Dre was $800 million, like you said before, with mm-hmm. Dr. Dre, when you were saying that he bought into Apple with the Dre headphones and the Beats,
mm-hmm.
but then for some reason something went wrong.
Yeah, you know, him and Jimmy Iovine got a certain mathematical percentage, and Jimmy Iovine became the billionaire. But his percentage was a little lower. That's why he only stopped at 800.
But he claimed himself
at first.
Self-proclaimed billionaire.
At first,
mm-hmm.
before they did the calculation. And then he had to pump his brakes and tell him, oh. But hey, man, 800 mil.
That's still right. I'm not going to turn it down.
Come on, man. Like, come on. All
right. I'm not going to turn it down to 800 mil. You know.
Right.
So moving forward with the next topic is, you know, the current state of hip-hop. And, you know, we talked a lot about the changes in hip hop and a lot of negative trends that we see. And Lil Durk.
Lil Durk.
King Von. Now the situation with them. You heard about that?
Yeah. I seen not too long ago Lil Durk turned himself in.
Mm-hmm.
And then I just seen recently they said they had a video of him actually shooting at the victim or shooting at the person that's the intended victim. So that's kind of tough.
Right. And it says the judge finds probable cause to charge him with attempted murder. Do you?
I hear echo.
Yeah. So the judge found the probable cause to charge them with murder. Do you? I don't really know. I haven't seen the video.
Nah, I don't know if anybody had a video of the actual shooting. I didn't see it, but the prosecutor said they had it. So, pretty much could bet on that right there. But it's just the whole current state of hip hop, man. Everybody's locked up. Everybody's in jail. Soulja Boy, Kodak Black, NBA Youngboy, Lil Durk, King Von, the list goes on.
And Soulja Boy.
Yeah. And it's just the state of hip hop, man. I almost fell victim to it. You know, I got a couple felonies. I've been downstate a whole bunch of times, and is a you have to distinguish between the streets and your music.
Mm-hmm.
Can't do both.
Right.
If you're doing the streets and your music, one is going to take out the other. As soon as you're getting close to your music, here come a new charge. Here come a new jail time. Here come a new lawyer fees. So, you know, state of hip hop is in flux. But, you know, I guess it's time for the new flux to come in right now.
True. Do you think that has a lot to do with where a lot of the rappers are coming from, you know, what they're seeing in the environment, and then they're talking about a true story, you know what I mean, what they experienced in the hood growing up, and that's what pretty much sells. Do you think that's this?
I think, you know, once you get in the door, that's where you came from. That's cool.
Mm-hmm.
Once you're making the bread, there's still, look, Lil Durk and them is their charge is shooting at a victim, allegedly. Robbing them for $30,000,
mm-hmm.
chain, and a car. That's his charge. Mm-hmm. Look it up. I seen it. Prosecutor seen it.
Mm-hmm.
Once you get to a certain status, why are you robbing people? Why are you shooting people?
If you have the money.
If you could pay me to do shows, I'm getting $20,000, $20,000, $15,000, whatever, a show.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not robbing you, bro.
Right, that's true.
You could go on, have a nice day.
Mm-hmm.
Get away from me, bro. That's how I'm coming. But it's the OGs that's in the clique. You know, it's the older mentors that's in the clique that got to say, nah, we don't do that no more.
Right, we don't do it.
That's it. We used to rob. Now we making money. That's it.
Mm-hmm.
But if you got the OGs saying, yeah, man, let's, yeah, then you're going to see what we're seeing now. So I think it's a lot of people that's in position got to lead follow.
Yeah. And I think it's a start because, you know, downtown they have the downtown North. They having the event now. King Stop Killing Kings.
Yeah.
They have that. So I think that's probably a start for them to do things like that.
Yeah. As far as the thing in North, like I said, I just came home about 2 years ago, 2.5 years ago. When I first came home, that's when we had the whole shooting thing.
Mm-hmm.
And before I had my car, before I was even fancy, I used to be catching a bus. I used to go downtown Newark, and they used to have parades and rallies, mm-hmm. Black Lives Matter and City Hall signs. And I was like, wow.
Right.
I just came home like, wow.
Mm-hmm.
Then, stop.
Right.
So basically saying is just keep the movement alive.
Keep whatever it alive.
Movement
right.
It is, women's movement, power movement, hip hop movement.
Mm-hmm.
Keep it alive, bro.
We're losing too many brothers and sisters out here. So it's good to set a positive example. And it starts with the lyrics that we put in the music, too. Like, that's why I do appreciate the Black mm-hmm. Men Don't Cheat.
Yeah. You know? Every lyric, like, if you listen to my song, my stuff is kind of trap music and it's kind of raw,
mm-hmm.
you know, because I haven't made it yet. So what I'm speaking is actually what I'm living.
Mm-hmm.
Now, once I get to a certain position, then your music should grow as you grow.
As you grow.
10 years or 5 years, you've been getting paid. You shouldn't be talking about robbing people at that point.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but, you know, people put in their music.
So before we go on a break, though,
mm-hmm.
I just wanted to make one last, you know, point about you. I do notice the difference, too, is when somebody does make it and when they evolve,
mm-hmm.
I feel like it doesn't sell. You know, just like when you make it to a certain and you start talking about elevation and you start talking about what you have and what you don't see that anymore, I feel like sometimes it, how would you make music for, you know?
Well, I look at it like this. Mm-hmm. You know, you can't feed a baby steak. Mm-hmm. What that means is that the positive food, that steak, that's the whole meal. Mm-hmm. Certain people not ready right now. Sometimes you might have to relate to them. You know, they might be in the trap. Mm-hmm. They might be in the grind. They might be actually robbing at this particular point. Mm-hmm. And you, the music that you drop has to relate to them. Once you relate to them, then he likes you and he becomes a fan of yours once you can relate to him. Mm-hmm. And then as you grow, he should be able to grow with you. You know what I'm saying? It's like a joint venture right there.
So we're going to take a break on that note.
Okay.
All right.
Hip hop.
I like that.
Hey, man.
Tell me how you want it. I give it to you good. I'm that nigga from the hood, girl. I ain't Hollywood. Hop up in this drop top. We could take a cruise. I know your girl telling you I be bad news. I'm in and out of the trap house, that black house. Fuck what you heard. I'm going to the hole like Stackhouse. Big money bags all up in my pocket. Niggas, haters everywhere. Looking, trying to stop a nigga. I don't give a fuck about cops and them DTs. Niggas want to squeeze. Put me on a shirt. Niggas, what it's worth. I'm the nigga going hard on the turf. Peace to my earth. Can't you tell a nigga bulletproof? I'm back in the flesh. I'ma go hard till it ain't nothing left to a nigga out of breath. Can't you tell I'm out of space again? And I got the coke. Niggas see me coming up the block and niggas start chasing them. Cocaine flow, hit them with that dope shit. Niggas nowadays be talking but they don't quote shit. Me and my niggas on the block, my niggas post shit. Fuck what you heard, you get roast quick. I'm that nigga. You can tell me how you want it. Fish scale, crystals all on it.
Tell me how you want it.
I can take you to the mo. Beat it up or do it real slow. We can travel around the world, do our thing, baby. You could be my girl.
Tell me how you want it.
These haters can't get it from me. We can shoot it out or go get this money.
Tell me how you want it.
Tell me how you want it. Soft for the hard. Every time I'm in a booth, man, I'm giving it raw. Every time I'm in a booth, man, I'm showing no flaw. It's the nigga hopping out, leaving bitches in awe. Haters wanna see me in the casket, nigga. My pops died young, turned me to a bastard, nigga. But I'm ready to fly, I'm ready to fight. I'm that gasoline torch that's ready to ignite. Y'all niggas cross me, but I'm ready to floss. I don't answer to nobody, I'm the work and the boss. Get that coke in and I'm getting it off. Get money every day cause I'm destined to floss. Take her to the room, all you see is bubbles splashing. Phone ringing off the hook with shorty about that action. Take her to the shower and I'm making money by the hour. Chilling while I'm blowing dower.
How you want it?
You can tell me how you want it. Fish scale, crystals all on it.
Tell me how you want it.
I could take you to the mo. Beat it up or do it real slow.
Tell me how you want it.
We could travel around the world, do our thing, baby. You could be my girl.
Tell me how you want it.
These haters can't get it from me. We can shoot it out or go get this money.
Tell me how you want it.
We're back.
Oh.
And here with me is Supreme Justice.
Supreme
rapper,
Justice,
Jersey
the energy
rapper.
God in the building.
So now going into the interview.
Let's go.
For all of the independent artists, this is one thing that we want to hear. Is it really money in independent, being an independent artist?
Yeah, it's a lot of money in the independent style.
Mm-hmm.
But to get the money, you got to build a brand. And that's what I'm in the process of trying to do, is build a brand. any artist just coming out, you ain't gonna make a whole bunch of money until you build a brand. And now it's a lot easier than it was before, because mm-hmm. before, as an artist, you had to be with the record label,
right?
You know, but now you can use Instagram and get a whole bunch of followers and a whole wave going that the label's gonna start running at you because you already got the wave right. going. And that's the difference between then and now. Back then, they'd grab you and create a wave.
Mm-hmm.
Now,
you can create your own wave.
They don't even want to talk to you unless mm-hmm. you already got a wave. And that's good or bad, because like me, I'm a good artist, but I ain't a real social media mogul type person. I probably need to pay somebody to just work straight my social media to mm-hmm. get my joint popping, 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 as it should.
Yeah.
But, you know, nowadays, they just, when you go to the labels, you go to the execs, you go to the meetings, they ain't asking you, they don't even want to hear your song.
Right.
How many followers you got? Have.
I agree.
How many YouTube views you getting on your videos? Mm-hmm. How many hits on your SoundClick? That's all they really looking for right now.
That
they
is.
Don't even care. Because if you listen to the state of hip hop, it ain't people in the game that's nice. You ain't hearing people like,
exactly.
Like, yo, how you looking like, how the hell did he even get in the game?
Right.
The reason you're saying that is because they have a certain type of media presence that's mm-hmm. allowing them to get in the game. And mm-hmm. that's something that we all need at this point, especially
right.
me.
You know, I feel like you got to have a following. You have to have something behind you. So you're right about that. You hit it right on the nail with that. So do you believe that we don't really need to, right now, we don't really need to have a record label? Or do you feel?
I think you should build up your brand to the point where record labels is hitting you, and then if you're going to sign,
mm-hmm.
have a bidding war, like, raise the price. It's just like, you know, Hustler, you know, you come out and you have something that people want, mm-hmm. you got more than, he wants it for five, he wants it for six, hey, sell it for seven, you know
right.
what I mean? So basically what I'm saying is just, you know, just build up your brand, have the labels contact you, and then if you do want to sign, make the best decision.
I saw on your Instagram page you had record label up there. What was mm-hmm. that about?
I had a few record labels, you know, talking slick. But at the end of the day, they saying, yo, your music is fire. We really, really, really like your music. But we want your whole social media thing to elevate. So, you know, that's what I'm trying to do right now. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's where I'm at right now. You know, as far as music, I can make a song right now on the spot. It don't matter.
Mm-hmm.
But it's all about getting the proper exposure.
Right. They don't appreciate talent too much anymore.
Nah, it's not about talent. Back mm-hmm. in the day, you had to have talent to get in the industry.
Right.
Now, it's all about, you know, do you got social media to get in the industry, if you ask me.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel hip-hop is dead?
Hip-hop is alive. Hip-hop is dead to what it used to be.
Mm-hmm.
What I mean by that, now when I was doing hip-hop, I'm an 80s baby, man. I ain't gonna front around mm-hmm. here like I'm one of these super young dudes. I'm an 80s baby.
Mm-hmm.
But I seen hip-hop make the transition from, you know, CDs and physical copies to actual digital copies.
Right.
Now it's all about streams, and it's all about downloads and
yes.
all that, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So the old hip-hop is dead. CD, tape, all that's dead. That's
mm-hmm.
that. When they say hip-hop is dead, I see that. But hip-hop is alive now because it opened up a whole new digital era
mm-hmm.
for young artists and older artists to still get a shot at this new era, which is called the digital era, if you ask
yeah.
me.
And there's still a lot of decent artists out, you know?
Yeah, there's a lot of decent artists.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a lot of nice, I be doing a lot of Jersey shows, man. Anybody know me, man? I'm in the Jersey market. Ain't nobody that did a show, Newark, Elizabeth, and mm-hmm. this Jersey up here that ain't heard of Supreme Justice, because I'm out there.
Mm-hmm.
But it's time for us to get this exposure, man.
Mm-hmm.
And it's time for people that's in higher places to reach down and grab somebody, bro.
Yeah, I saw you perform at Mr. G's one time.
And oh, you did?
Yeah, oh, I saw it on
okay,
his.
Okay.
You
okay,
had the place okay. lit. I can say that. Like,
yeah, I'm the energy guy.
Mm-hmm, energy, definitely.
Yeah, when I come in the building, mm-hmm. I ain't coming in the building for people to sit down. If you ain't standing up, if you ain't feeling the energy, then I'm going to give you the energy. And that's what's my name, Supreme Justice, the energy guy.
What are some other places you performed?
Man, I done lost count, man. I done performed every place in Jersey. I done lost count. I done lost count. But I done did so many shows to the point now it's like, man, I'm trying to get paid.
It gets
paid
tired.
Nah.
If that goes to any independent artist, period, entrepreneurs, I feel you. You know,
I did so much shows that people asking me, yo, what's up with your shows? Why you ain't been doing a lot of shows lately?
Yeah, I was going to ask you that too.
This is my thing. I've been doing shows for a while, and I've been doing shows for free. You know, I've been going out
doing shows for free.
Wow. They don't want to pay you.
Mm-hmm.
They're not going to pay you to do a show unless you got a social media status. Here we go. We going back to this total thing again.
Mm-hmm.
So my whole goal now was to do that part.
Mm-hmm.
That's where it's at. So, I could do a show. I just did a show maybe like 2-3 weeks ago. But I'm not doing shows every week, every 3 weeks and all that like I did. Because right now I'm trying to focus on getting it to the point where people going to pay me for my work. I'm tired of doing free service.
Yeah. No, I agree with that. It's sometimes people don't be willing to pay, but you got to do what you got to do.
Yeah.
So... Who is your inspiration? Who do you feel like you sound the most like to me?
I never mimic my style behind anybody. I never really, like, nowadays, everybody's sound is almost the same. Like, you know, if I hear somebody, I could be like, you sound like Lil Baby, or he sound like Lil Gunna, he sound like this guy, he sound like somebody.
Do people say you sound like Lil Baby?
Not me. No, I'm just saying the music that I hear now, everybody is patterning themselves behind somebody else.
Mm-hmm.
When I grew up in hip-hop, you know, like even the Wu-Tang, I don't want nobody sounding like me on no record. Like, that's how it was when I was growing up in hip-hop. Like, you got your style, that is you.
Mm-hmm.
Don't be out here trying to mimic nobody's style. Be yourself. And that's what I am. You know, I could do different songs and different styles, but at the end of the day, I don't mimic myself behind nobody.
Mm-hmm.
But I do have inspirations. I like Jay-Z.
Mm-hmm.
I like Nas. Mm-hmm. I grew up on Jeezy. That's my boy. I grew up on Rick Ross. All the trap Ross, shit. That's me. That's
you are
my
80s baby.
I'm an 80s baby. Now they be like, damn, he like Rick Ross and Jeezy. But I'm an 80s baby, and that's the era that I was in.
They don't know nothing about that.
They don't know about that. If it ain't little,
Little Uzi Vert.
Little
everybody. Everybody's a little.
Yeah, everybody's little, man. Yeah. If it ain't somebody little, they don't know.
Little
so.
Young dirties.
Little young dirties, bro. If they not them, then they don't know about them. So.
Yeah.
So I'm like kind of like the bridge, man. You know, I could still do some of that stuff. Yeah. You know, I wouldn't mind.
I do want somebody to change the game, though. Yeah. I want somebody to set a new type of style because I am a little tired of hearing everybody sound the same. Everybody want to whine? It seemed like hip hop starting to change to R&B sometimes.
Yeah, everybody.
And it's like, okay,
singing,
so
you know,
right?
You know, I don't get you know, like. When I first, I've lived long enough to say that hip-hop really did a 360.
Because
when I was coming up in hip-hop, you know, at that time with the whole 50 Cent, Ja Rule, the whole singing, if you was singing on a record, you was kind of look like, whoa, you singing on a record? You ain't an R&B singer. Like, you know, that was the whole thing. And then 50 Cent made it cool singing on a record, but he was talking gangsta.
And then Drake was doing it.
And
he started singing.
Drake singed on a record and made it commercial.
Yeah, definitely.
So now everybody's singing a record. I can't sing. I ain't even going front. If I'm
auto-tune.
Gonna do, yeah, I ain't even gonna do auto tune. I'm gonna keep it real. I'm gonna get somebody else that sings and do the auto tune. Let him do what he do, and I'm gonna do what
you
I do.
You know what? I think that'll be interesting hearing a singing track from you. You know,
yeah,
auto tune track. Yeah. Maybe you might want to do one.
Yeah, my next track I'm gonna sing you gonna be an auto tune singing track.
This one for the ladies, right?
Straight ladies, yeah. Singing, dropping on one knee type stuff. You know?
Yeah, and it might be you know a different look. So
a hit record, you never know.
Yeah. So soon we're gonna go into freestyle, you know. So
okay, we still got the self-made joint. We got one more joint, or we gonna go straight to freestyle?
The one you picked, right? The one you showed me.
Mm-hmm.
And don't say self-made.
Listen.
Say important. That's the name of the track. You got something in your
It's
track?
Three. It was. It's still in the three. It's still in the three. Songs.
That's the list right here. Which one did you pick?
It was self-made. It was
your song.
Money
yeah,
song.
My song self-made. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And we get to that track.
Yeah.
Yeah, so all right, so before we can play that track.
How much time we got?
Yeah, we got. Yeah, we can play the track, and then we come back. We'll do the freestyle. Okay.
Talk a little bit.
All right. Yeah, but talk. All right.
Self-made street shit.
With Supreme Justice.
Justice in the building. Self-made. You know, everybody out there that's self-made, stand up.
Yeah.
So soon we're going to go into a freestyle. We're just going to chat a little bit.
Yes.
You know, we're going to talk about some of your goals. What are your goals?
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm like, what, like hip-hop or life? Which one? In general, that's two separate goals there.
It could be hip-hop. It could be entrepreneurship.
All right. I'm going to do both then.
Mm-hmm.
My goals in hip-hop. Like, I ain't really like a young guy, so this is my goal. I'm trying to get in, kick in the door, bang, right? Hit them with everything I can hit them with, bang. I got a record label, Straight Drop Music. I got a lot of young artists, teenagers, you know, that's going to come up. That's the next wave. So me, I'm just trying to kick in some doors, man. Bang, bang, kicking some doors, get some checks. Do some networking and then open the door. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna do what I said that people aren't doing in Jersey. Get in the door and put other people in the door. See, I'm not the type of person that's I get in, I don't want you to get in. I'm going to get you in. We're going to do a little payment thing. We're going to do a little mathematical equation here.
Investment.
Now, I ain't going to sit here and lie now.
That's right. That's right.
But we're going to get you in there, and we all going to be happy, man. Anything
sounds
else
like
is
a
uncivilized,
plan.
Man.
Add
anything
me on the list.
Hey, man. Anything else is uncivilized, man.
Right.
Like, before Fetty Wap, who was after that? Naughty by Nature? You got to go like 10 years.
Yeah.
Look at the gap between people. Yeah. It's crazy.
And shout out to Patterson, too.
Shout out to Patterson. So,
yeah.
You know, I just
want rappers in Patterson, too.
There's rappers everywhere, man.
Yeah.
There's rappers everywhere all over the globe. But
Jersey
has, it's like a cesspool of talent.
Definitely.
You know? And somebody gotta be the one to expose it, man. And if it ain't somebody, then it gotta be me, then. Somebody, man. Somebody. Nobody, I'm in the room, and it has to be done. And I'm looking around, and ain't nobody standing up. So I guess I'm gonna have to do the standing up, then, man. Jersey in the building. Let's get it.
Yes. Any up-and-coming rappers, Jersey rappers, independent artists that you saw, had your eye on, that you want to do a collabo with?
I'm going to shout out my boy Charlie B. He out here on my live. I want to shout out my nigga Lil Neef. That's my guy. I want to shout out my guy Brock. He on my live right now. Brock Diamond, that's my guy. We got some features. My boy, all my people's down on Full Block. That's my guys. Yo, man, I'll be running out of names, man. Jersey got so much talent that if I keep saying names, somebody gonna be like, yo, you left me out. You left me out. But nah, I can't leave nobody out. I'm just gonna say, Jersey, we in the building, man.
Okay, all right. And what is a normal day for you like? Yeah, I wanna know what you do.
Tell what I'll do on the live. I will not be around a lot longer, but what I do, I'm an engineer too. You know what I mean? I have a degree in recording. I'm a recording engineer.
Okay.
You know, I'm familiar with the knobs. She over there working. Pro
much
Tools.
Respect.
Yeah, Pro Tools. Yeah, Pro Tools. Any artists need to come to my studio, the Grindhouse. Hit your boy up on Instagram at Supreme Justice. So my normal day is really, man, you know, trying to get to the bag. If anybody need a session, holler at me. I be at the Meadowlands too, man. I'm a gambler, man. I ain't gonna stunt. I'm a gambler. All my guys that be in the gambling spots. So I'm everywhere. So my normal day, I don't have a set normal day. I just wake up and go with the flow.
Go with the flow. Okay. All right. So y'all ready for a freestyle?
Oh yeah, we can spit a couple bars, man. All
right.
Let
you wanna
Jersey
hear something?
Know that you know, we still in the building.
Okay. All right.
It's too many, Charlie,
too
man.
Too many beats.
Oh. Turn me up in the headphones a little bit, though.
They can hear it
out there. Play it out there so they can hear it, yeah.
Headphones good?
Do you turn it up here? Out here? Oh, it won't do it, right? But
can
they hear it?
They
can
hear it. That's why I need to do it.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. All right, well, let's go with it, man. I ain't going to play with it. I'm about to stand up, though, man.
Here we go.
Yeah.
Oh, wait. Let me go.
Yo, catch me in the booth, blazing the chronic. Or catch me in the bar, raising hypnotic. I'm a monster with no 20s on the Tonka. Trees that I burn the same color as Blanca. I do this with no sponsors, it's just me.
Yes.
I be on the dolo cause misery need company. So I chill, I hit my peoples like, what's good, homie? I put the stash up cause cops want them cuffs on me. I'm on a late night, eyes like a brake light. Headed to the rest, the right rhymes to stay tight. I'm about to take flight just like a shuttle. Why these cats talking like they got bricks in they bubble? When you see them in the streets and the beef kick off, be the same ones running before the heat lick off. I ain't dice with the ice, but with mics I floss. My 16's like a Christian, they cross, so you get lost. Pause and give a moment of silence to all the fallen soldiers that died, fell victim to violence. Life's a challenge, I'm just trying to keep it all balanced and stack bread. I'm not blue or red, it's just me, the son of Ned. Not in dread, but my birthplace is from Jamaica. I'm from the bricks where they steal your whip, see you later. I drop the illest data, I write like an innovator. Why they bite rhymes, I recreate like an innovator.
Wow.
I got no time for no fake
fake MCs. Rather take my little June or Chuck E. Cheese. I hit the mall, caught my Dunce and Tims. While they frontin' in they rhymes like they riding around town in some rims. Talking ice this and ice that. Keep talking that. The only ice you gonna get is an ice pack. I strike back for the empire. Niggas frontin' like they nice. Supreme Justice, he been fire.
Wow. I wish I would've got the whole thing. That was dope.
Whoa, did the beat stop right there? Did the beat stop right there?
Stop, bro.
Oh, man, the beat stopped.
Damn. I wish I had the whole thing because the other part that I had, it went on.
Oh, man.
Okay.
Wow. Okay. Drop the illest data. They over here. They over here on the line.
Yeah, that was fire.
Drop
that was
the illest data. Yeah.
I'm going to have to get that off of video. Ooh. Okay, y'all. Supreme Justice did his thing.
Hey, that was off the little something. Shout out to all my Jersey artists trying to make it, trying to kick in the door. And when you do kick in the door, make sure you reach back and get your brother. I don't even care if it's me. Reach back and get your brother. Jersey, let's get it. Yeah,
yeah. Okay, well, thanks for coming. Yeah. Thanks for coming. That was real. That was tough.
Yeah. Hey, I want thanks for having me. Mm-hmm. The show is popping. Let's get it. Keep continuing the movement. Keep continuing the vibe. Love y'all.
And where can they find you?
Hit me up, man. I got to get all these social media stuff down packed, but you could definitely hit me up on IG, Supreme Justice IG. You could click, I got some videos on there. If you need some music, hit me up. I'm about to be dropping a project this soon. I'm about to shoot a video probably around the July 4th weekend. I'm not sure what song I'm gonna do, but we're gonna have it all in place. So just go to my IG, check my stories, check my posts, and we're gonna take it from there.
All right, well, thanks for tuning in, everyone. This is Indie Dreams every Saturday at 6 p.m. And shout out to Joyce, the engineer. Grace, the engineer.
Okay, Grace.
Thank you. Thanks. Thanks for tuning in.
You already.
All right, see you next week.
Let's get it. Supreme. Bye.